Hello everyone, today I'm going to be showing you a process I use for smoothing the surface of an FDM 3D printed part. I'll be using Milliput putty and Smooth-On XTC-3D to smooth the surface of this PLA plastic roll cage I'll be using on an upcoming build. The part looks good as is, especially for something that will be mounted to the inside of the vehicle and therefore won't be that visible, but taking the extra step to smooth and paint the surface of this part will definitely make a noticeable improvement to the appearance and scale realism of the part. Especially when considering how easy the process is, the low cost of materials, and the relatively short time needed to complete the process. The first thing I want to do is sand the surface to remove any large imperfections on the part, and provide a slightly rough surface for the Milliput to adhere to. Extensive sanding is not necessary. You only need to focus on large imperfections since the putty and XTC-3D coating will take care of any smaller bumps or holes on the part's surface. After sanding, I use a wet paper towel to remove all the dust. Once the surface is dry, I can add the Milliput. If you aren't familiar with Milliput, it's a multi-purpose two-part epoxy putty that can be used for a wide variety of applications, including model making. Milliput comes in a variety of different types and colors designed for specific applications, but the application process is pretty much the same for all types. I'm using Milliput Black for this part. If you want more information about Milliput, I've included a link below in the description. Using Milliput is very simple. Just blend equal parts of each putty until the color is uniform. Once mixed, I thin the putty with water and apply it to any holes and depressions on the surface of the roll cage. Here's a look at the roll cage after letting the putty cure overnight. It's now fully cured and can be sanded. Milliput is very easy to sand, so you don't need to worry too much about thick spots since sanding it smooth shouldn't be difficult. Here, I'm using a file for any large bumps, and then we'll go over the entire surface with sandpaper. Already, the surface of the part is looking and feeling much smoother. Next, I wiped off the dust created by the filing and sanding in preparation of the resin coating. Now I can begin to apply the XTC-3D coating. This product is pretty popular among those in the 3D printing community. If you're unaware of it, it's basically a resin coating that is brushed onto the surface of a 3D printed part that creates a smooth, glossy surface finish that can be sanded and painted if desired. I've used this product many times before, and it's generally my preferred method for smoothing 3D printed parts on applications like this. I'll be sure to include a link in the description to the webpage for this product, where you can learn more about it. All you have to do before applying is mix part A and part B either 2:1 by volume or 100:42 by weight. Mix both parts thoroughly, and then apply the mixture to the part's surface. Of course, be sure to read all the included documentation provided by Smooth-On. They have great detailed instructions and important safety information. Gloves, long sleeves, respirator, and safety glasses are all highly recommended. One thing to keep in mind is that there isn't any way to clean your brush after applying the coating, at least none that I'm aware of, so be sure you are using a disposable brush. The coating fully cures at room temperature in about 2 hours, however, cure time can be reduced by using heat. I repeated the process of mixing and applying to add a second coat to the part. Here's a look at the roll cage after the second coat of XTC-3D. I decided that two coats would be enough for this part, so I began filing down any sections where the coating was a bit too thick, and sanded the entire surface of the part to allow for better paint adhesion. I painted the roll cage with satin black krylon spray paint. And here is the painted roll cage. As you can see, the surface is smooth and doesn't show any layers. It only takes a little bit of time, effort, and material to make a 3D printed part look smooth. The surface of this part isn't 100% smooth all around. There are still a few imperfections here and there that could have been eliminated with additional sanding and filling. However, being an interior mounted roll cage, I didn't feel that it was necessary to spend the extra time making the surface perfectly smooth. Like with many things, it all comes down to how much time you're willing to spend on a particular component. In total, I don't think I spent more than an hour or two working on this piece, so it doesn't take much time to get good results like this. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section below, and I will do my best to answer it. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate it if you click the like button below and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.